everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn what arc length and arc measure are, and how to calculate them. If you have not already completed the activity in your notes template titled Calculating Circumference, please do so before proceeding with this video. If you haven't, then pause here and complete it now. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to find arc length and arc measure of a given circle. First, we'll define arc measure and arc length. Next, we'll discuss the formula used to calculate arc length. And finally, we'll complete an example problem. Let's start by defining arc measure. Arc measure can be defined as the angle an arc makes with the center of the circle. Remember that an arc is part of the circumference. Let's use arc UP as an example here. Arc UP opens up to angle URP at the center of the circle. According to our definition, this central angle measure is our arc measure too. If the central angle measure is 137 degrees, then the arc measure is also 137 degrees. The arc measure and corresponding central angle measure will always equal each other. Our other new term is arc length. This is the distance along an arc. The arc length is a part of the circle's circumference. A circle's entire circumference can be calculated as 2 times pi times r, with r representing the radius of the circle. The arc length will just be a portion of that entire circumference, depending on how far along the circle the arc reaches. Let's say you want to know the arc length of this semicircle. We know how to calculate the length of the entire circumference by using our circumference formula and substituting the radius in. We can simplify this further by multiplying 2 and 5 together. But what about just the semicircle? How can we find the length of that if we know the length of the entire circumference? We can take half of the circumference. Okay, so this seems great, but what if we have an arc that isn't a nice fraction of the circumference, like this one was with the 1/2? What if the arc looks like this, and it's a lot more difficult to tell how far around the circle this arc is going? Here are the calculations from earlier of the entire circumference. But what can we multiply this by to get the length of this arc? How many degrees are there if we go all the way around the circle? There are 360 degrees all the way around the circle. So if we're only using 123 of those, how do you think that could help us find the arc length? We can multiply the entire circumference by 123 over 360. We could think of this as taking the central angle measure over 360 and then multiplying it by the entire circumference. And remember that the central angle measure matches the arc measure. So if we were given the arc measure instead, we could use that value divided by 360. This leads us to our formula for arc length. Here's our formula. In this formula, we have the symbol theta, the symbol pi, and r to represent the radius. Remember, this part represents the arc measure or central angle measure. And this part here represents the entire distance around the circle. Now, remember how back at the beginning of this lesson, we were able to find the arc length of a semicircle without this formula? Let's go back to this for a moment. Remember how we were looking for the arc length of this semicircle? We had the entire circumference and just took half of it. Let's connect this idea to the equation we just made and use a fraction with 360 in the denominator instead. What would this central angle measure be for a semicircle? It would be 180 degrees. What happens when we put this in the equation? Now, what does 180 over 360 simplify to? That's right, it's the 1/2 that we had earlier. Now that we've explored this formula and understand where it comes from, let's try an example problem. This says, find the measure of arc AB to the nearest whole number, and the length of RAB to the nearest tenth. So we need to find two things here. Which of these is the easiest to find with the information given to us in the picture? The arc measure is easiest because it's going to match the central angle that it corresponds to. So what is the measure of arc AB? It's 57 degrees, just like the central angle. Now, what about the arc length? Can you set up the equation for this and substitute values in? Or maybe you remember that it's part of the circumference. You could calculate the circumference and then take a fraction of that based on how far around the circle it goes. Pause the video now and see if you can solve for the arc length to the nearest tenth. Did you substitute 57 in for theta and 4.2 in for the radius? Then we can type all this into the calculator and get a decimal approximation and round it to the tenths place. If you are unable to correctly type this into the calculator of your choice, there are calculator instruction PDFs available in the teaching section of this lesson to help you. Be sure to locate the PDF that applies to your calculator and make sure that you can get this problem correct before moving on to the practice game. Anyways, now we have both parts of our answer. Now you know what arc measure and arc length represent on a circle and how to find them. Remembering those details you've learned along the way will help you breeze through the practice game, and I'll put this into your long-term memory. See you next time!